See No Evil is a 2006 slasher movie starring Kane from WWE at the time as Jacob Goodnight. He is a vicious, super-sized killer who at the beginning of the film has done a massacre, and the police show up. He's able to kill one of them and maim another, but he ends up getting shot in the head, and it sort of slows him down, but he escapes. And many years later, like 4 years later, the same one-armed cop is now working at a penitentiary, and with his partner, is developed a program to use delinquent youths to do community service to help shave off their delinquent time, I guess. I don't know if they're in prison. I guess they are in prison. I'm not really sure, to be honest. Or they could be in juvie. Either way, they have to basically, there's eight of them, and they basically have to help clean out an abandoned museum slash hotel over the course of 3 days to knock a month off of their sentences. So they all go there, and they have to be locked in, of course. So they don't, obviously, they're convicts. They can't just run away. So this movie basically is just a lot of setup. You know, there's eight convicts. They some of them know each other. One of them is like an ex-prostitute and clashes with her ex-pimp. And then there's like the thieves and the criminals. They have special skills like lock picking and things like that. And none of them are super dangerous though. They're all like, you know, petty crime thieves or pimps or whatever. And then there's the cop. However, there's someone there, and it's Jacob Goodnight. He's there. He's been hiding out. He violently starts killing them with a giant hook and chain weapon, and he's like relentless, and he's like, he knows this museum hotel in the back of his hand, like the back of his hand, because he lives there. And there's some, you know, pretty terrible editing in this movie, to be honest. I don't know, the camera is just all over the place. The kills are mostly off screen. I don't know if it's a budget thing, because this movie has a pretty decent budget of $8 million. So I don't know why a lot of the gore is off screen. It is a hard R slasher. Just, you know, the only reason why I watched it was because I saw this at a store for a dollar. And then, you know, I'm in the mood to watch Halloween or scary movies, you know, even the bottom of the barrel slashers. And this one is definitely a bottom of the barrel slasher. Not that awful, to be honest. I mean, like, the acting from everyone's fine. You got the chick from Jessica Jones in an earlier role, and they don't do an awful job. And there's a couple twists, but I think the best, you know, parts of the movie is the last maybe half hour. The rest of the movie is just sort of, you know, watching criminals bicker. And then when, you know, finally gets to the killing part, you get the lean, you know, killing machine in there, but it's not anything special. Like, the kills aren't really shown. They're all off screen. There's minimal gore. Only the last like 30 minutes is worth it. It has some pretty sweet stunt work, but you know, with Kane and everything. But overall, yeah, I mean, it's like, you know, an attempt to make a new franchise, I guess, but it was just okay. You know, it's something you can put on, watch once, and forget. It's definitely not good enough to be like a yearly watch for me. So I give See No Evil a 5 out of 10. See No Evil 2 is a direct-to-video sequel to See No Evil. 9 years later, this movie has the return of Kane as Jacob Goodnight. However, it is the takes place immediately after the events of the first film. So a couple of paramedics are trying to bring Jacob Goodnight back to life. However, he dies. And following some morgue technicians, Amy is a very young, beautiful woman who Seth, her coworker, has a crush on her, but he won't ask her out. However, it's her birthday, so she's supposed to go and do birthday stuff. However, she decides to stay overtime because of the massacre. The bodies are coming over. She decides to stay with her, you know, the guy she likes. And the two of them are going to work through the night with their boss, who's in a wheelchair. However, her friends decide to throw her an impromptu birthday bash at the morgue with the permission of her boss. So now there's a whole bunch of med students there. And Tamara and her boyfriend are, she's like a morbid curiosity sort of lady. So she goes off to like touch the body and look at it. And then Jacob Goodnight is alive, and he starts butchering everyone in the hospital. So it's a kind of a Halloween 2 situation. This movie's definitely not as good as Halloween 2, though. I thought this one would be better than the first one because I really like the cast. You've got Michael Eklund, you've got Daniel Harris. However, there's not much for them to do. The story's very threadbare. You're starting off with like this sort of will they, won't they romance, and then they throw in this brother character of Amy. He's like a jerk who keeps trying to control her life, and it's kind of weird. And then, you know, Jacob Goodnight starts cutting into them anyway. And then the second half of this movie just has literally, like, no plot. It's kind of weird because there's not much to do. I mean, you know, they're in the morgue. They can leave if they get keys, but the boss has the keys. And it's all, like, playing around with, like, location. And you'd think this movie would just be Jacob Goodnight grabbing medical tools and fighting them or them fighting him. But there's not much fighting back. And it's, like, the second half of this movie is just kind of boring and not much going on. It's very low effort in terms of story because they can't come up with anything, I guess. You know, med students running around scared in the dark and this huge hulking 7-foot guy. They should have made the main protagonist more strong, I guess, like physically stronger or something. Or maybe they set a trap or something. They really have like nothing to do in the film. Like they're morgue technicians. They should know about anatomy and body. They should be able to like fight him, you know, or hit him with a defibrillator or something. This movie just feels really low effort. And you know, obviously, I watched it because it was on Prime, and I just watched the first one. So now I've completed the duology of the amazing See No Evil franchise. And honestly, I think Kane became a politician, so he's not acting anymore. But definitely not one of the better slasher films out there. So I give See No Evil 2 a 4 out of 10.